John, first of all, congratulations and welcome back to Tennessee. It's nice to have you here.
Bob, it's great to be back. You know, through the glory of satellite radio, driving back to my house after some ball games out in Kansas, I've been able to listen to you and Bert and Tim Priest and those guys, and it's always great to hear your voices, and you had an agent today.
Well, I don't know about that. It's nice getting you back. We don't need to give you a roadmap around here. You pretty much know your way around a little bit, and that's comforting too, I guess.
Well, I think one of the things that's incredible, I saw it when I came back for the K-State Tennessee basketball game last month, is how much has happened here. It's unbelievable how the campus has changed over the last 8 years, and all the new buildings and the new School of Music and the Tickle Engineering building, and it's really phenomenal. So I know where a lot of stuff used to be, and we'll see if I can find where everything is now.
But you had your hand in the development of the Pratt Pavilion, the Neyland Stadium project, softball. So you know a lot about what has gone on here in the past. That's got to help you going forward.
Absolutely. And also, I have a great deal of appreciation for the heritage of how we got to here with all these buildings. You know, you got this broad-based Tennessee family from all over the country that supports this program so passionately. And I still, going through airports and see people wearing the power tee and the orange, it always makes me think of Rocky Top and think of here. And to walk through some of these buildings, I mean, when I left, this space was a shell. Yeah. The top floor was a storage unit. And the Anderson Complex, which is incredible. I've never been in it until today, even though it was finished a number of years ago, but certainly was involved with some of the planning and fundraising for it 10 years ago.
John, you went to Kansas State and financial problems there. They had to get the facilities upgraded. You did all of that, got them back healthy financially. And during that time, you were able to kind of see the SEC. You were competing against the SEC.
Right.
So now kind of give us an overview as you're coming back to the conference and the challenges being in this league as an AD.
Well, you better bring it every day and every night, no matter what your sport, softball, baseball, basketball, you name it. It is a clearly an incredibly competitive conference. Now, the Big 12 is competitive, too, so I really want to not honor how competitive that league is. And in fact, one of the cool things that happened over the last 6 years as we went through some of the changes in college football with the CFP coming into play was the Sugar Bowl alliance between the Big 12 Conference and the Southeastern Conference. But all those folks down in the Southeastern Conference I've known forever. I was a huge proponent of Commissioner Slive, and then to have Greg Sankey be hired for that position. I told my president, if they don't hire Sankey there, we need to get him into our conference with Commissioner Bowlesby. More recently, there's been some new people hired at Alabama and Florida, and those two guys, Scott Strickland and Greg Byrne, they're among my very closest friends, Ross Bjork at Ole Miss, and so we're pretty competitive, all of us, our little group of ADs. I can't wait to get it on with those guys.
John, you had a staff meeting today when you first arrived on campus, and you said there are three major things that you always stress to your staff. Why don't you share that with the fans and how you push that?
Well, before I answer your question, Bob, I got to say that one of the cool things that happened to me at the University of Tennessee the first time when I was here for 10 years is the different kinds of people I met and being able to learn more about the broadness of an athletics program from Joan Cronin and Doug Dickey and lots of other people. But one of the things I heard from Carmen Togano a long time ago, there's three things we do. We got to win. We got to graduate our student athletes, and then we want our student athletes to be positioned to go get a job. Win, graduate, get a job. Now, there's a lot to that, right? And that's all under the framework of integrity and doing the right thing and representing our university the way we should represent it. But we have to remember, and it's real easy to forget these days, what's really important in this whole deal is our student athletes.
Your family is important to you, very important. And your kids are all born here. Now they get to come back. They already know where Kingston Pike is, and they know they've got a bunch of friends here. Does that make this transition easier for you as a family?
Absolutely. And, you know, my wife, we met the staff this morning, and then I haven't seen her since then. We bought all the orange ties in Manhattan, Kansas, but we are looking forward to updating our wardrobe a little bit. Actually, Bob, one of the folks in that office in the meeting this morning, he told me he actually had on one of the ties that I gave him when I left 8 years ago. So we're so excited, and this is an important place for our family. This community in this place is our family's home. All three of our kids. I got a letter from Dr. Johnson that somebody dropped off this morning. He signed my diploma in 2003. It's a very, very exciting moment for our family.
All right, you start here April 1st, so you got a month kind of to kind of get everything, move families and all those type things. Busy time, but I know you're excited about this.
I'm so fired up. And, you know, we're really fortunate. We got great leadership from Dave Hart, who's been a mentor of mine. I've admired his career from afar for a long time, and he's done a great job. And as I get here on April 1st, certainly I'm in touch with all of our folks. I've had great conversations with all of our head coaches over the last couple of days by telephone. I can't tell you how excited we are to get here.
John, welcome back. Good luck.
Thanks, Bob.
Good to see you.